Hello YouTube, this is Jesse from StemAPKs. Welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we're going to continue working with the Fultic library. And in this particular tutorial, we're going to be working with blending images, especially with alpha channels. So let's get started. The first thing you need to do is go to my GitHub page. So as you can see, Chesco345, and you go into repositories, go into the Fultic library, and here there will be all of the files that we've been working on this playlist with the Fultic. Anything related to Fultic, you can find it here. For example, some of these images are the ones that we created the animation with, and they're there. I have saved them there for you to keep them in case you wanna, you need images. They're there for you to download. So right now we're going to be working with the Alpha Blend C++ file. So what we're going to do, we're going to copy and paste. So we're just gonna go copy, and then we're gonna open a file called Alpha Blend C++. And you're going to copy and paste it, but as you can see, I already have it here. So in your case, you're just gonna copy and paste it. And let's talk about a little bit about the program here, the file. As you can see, we're including all of the dependencies from the Fultic library. Here, there's a class called Fultic Window. And what they're doing is two images, one on the right and one on the left. They're PNG images, but you can use anything. You can use JPEG also. All you need to do is put, instead of Fultic PNG image here, you just put Fultic JPEG image.h, and they're all available for you. This is to get the version of Fultic. And here, this is something new that we haven't done in another one of the tutorials. You're actually drawing on the image itself. So that's kind of cool. So this is the function here, the function draw. This is the font, draw, widget, the color, and then what's the text that is gonna go there, and also where are the coordinates in the X and the Y. So here is the images where they're going to be superimposed over one another. And here they continue loading the image. In this case, I'm going to do something different because I wanted to show you something. So I'm going to display red PNG. Is this PNG image, as you can see. And I'm also gonna run this one. I'm gonna display green PNG. As you can see, they're both very similar, same size. They're both, I believe, 256 by 256. Let me find out for sure. And I'm using Image Magic, as many of you know by now. I've used it in other tutorials. And as you can see here, there's a 256 by 256 on both images. And everything, the resolution is a little bit different. But as you can see, there is, there it is. I went too far. So it's the channel statistics. You have your red, your green, your blue, and your alpha channel. That's why you have these that you can see. And here also, you have your red, your green, your blue, and your alpha channel. Okay. So they're very similar, but they look the same, but they are not. And that's why I'm going to be using this as an example to see the things that could go wrong when we deal with this type of images. Let's load again the alpha blend image, C++. And here, instead of black PNG, we're going to do red PNG, and we're going to do green PNG. So let's compile it. So I think I have it here somewhere. There it is. And we're going to compile and compile. So now we're going to do alpha blend. And as you can see, they look exactly the same. But you can see the geometry and the 3D is a little bit off. That's why you have to be very careful when you do images. They have to be the same, especially when you're doing this type of alpha channel superimposing on one another. Because if not, they will have this type of offset issues. Okay, I just wanted to show you that. Make sure that the images are in. And if you have an image that has a different size, you can always use Image Magic. You can use convert the name of the image. Let's say it's called PNG, and then we call it resize. And whatever dimensions that you're using, in this case, I'm going to be using 256 by 256, and then exclamation mark. Very important, this exclamation mark, because you are actually forcing the resizing. Because by default, when you hit resize here, it might not resize the 256 by 256 like you want it. You might do a 256 by 225 because it's going to try to keep the resolution, the optimal resolution that it thinks it should have. So that exclamation mark, or the exclamation point there, will force Image Magic to stick to the dimensions that you have chosen. Very important. So here, if, for example, if you want to choose red PNG and convert it into red PNG into a 256 by 256. Keep the same name if you want to just keep the same image, so you don't want to copy it. Just so you just hit enter. And if you open now red PNG and we look at the info. We're going to see that it's a 256 by 256. So that's one way to make sure that they have the same image, the same geometry. And let's continue. I'm going to show you something that is very, it gets used a lot, especially when you're using avatars and Second Life and things like that on the internet. For example, you have this image, this type of material, and then this is the alpha channel that you're going to, obviously this is clothing. And then as you can see, when you combine this image with the alpha channel, you get this, you get that with the material. Okay, it's very popular, like I said, in Second Life or any of these internet-based type of applications. So I'm going to show you how this can be done easily with the Fulltech library. And in order to do that, I'm going to open my program again, same program. And all I got to do is change the images. So in this case, instead of red PNG, I'm going to use black PNG. And instead of green PNG there, I'm going to use Ubuntu PNG. And I'm going to display them to so you know what they look like. So display Apache, and this is what it is. It's just a, whoops, didn't mean to do that. This all it is a black image. There's a lot of black here, so it gets lost. So that's all it is. And the Ubuntu logo is display Ubuntu JPEG. I'm just going to show you the JPEG, what it looks like. And it's just the Ubuntu logo. But I'm going to be, instead of using the JPEG, I'm going to be using PNG because I created an alpha image with GIMP. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, you can always open GIMP and you can, if you want to add a channel, an alpha layer, alpha channel, all you need to go is open GIMP. GIMP comes with most Unix distributions. So all you need to do is open GIMP layer transparency and then add an alpha channel. But you need to have a file, an image open. That's why I created that PNG. So just open an image. Mostly PNG I like to work with, especially when I'm doing these type of things. So find, these are all JPEGs. Let's find this one, Alpha Ubuntu JPEG, no. Let's go here. And this is a good one right there, Ubuntu PNG. And then I open it, and as you can see, it's got an alpha channel. That when you see these squares, this is these are different layers. One is a transparent layer, and then one is an opaque layer. So this is all you need to do with GIMP. And if you don't remember what I did, all you need to do, cancel, is discard changes. So all you need to do is open the image that you want to add the channel to. It has to be let's try this one. Actually, this already has an alpha channel. So all you need to do, for example, this one. So you open it, and this one does not have an alpha channel. So all you need to do is go layer, transparency, add alpha channel. And here you can also do color to alpha. You can do other things that are more involved. But I don't want to get into it because GIMP is just, we can spend all day talking about GIMP. There's a lot of stuff there. It's a very powerful program. But let's, you get the idea. I'm just trying to show you. So just in case you don't have an image with an alpha channel, I'm showing you how to create it. But here we're going to display and use this program. So control X, yes, and then do compile, yes, and now alpha blend. And these are the images. And this is what you want to see. This is the, right now, is a combination of, as you can see, is this display black PNG. It's a combination of this image and also this image. Display Ubuntu PNG. So as you can see what I'm doing here, I have these two images right here, and they both superimpose on the same coordinates, and you get this image. And there's a lot of things, cool things that you can do with this application. That's why I wanted to make this video, because we'll be working with this and also integrating with OpenCV in future tutorials, so I just wanted you to start getting familiarized with this great library. So this is the end of this tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please click the like box, subscribe to my channel, follow me on GitHub, and I will see you next time with another tutorial. Have a great day. Take care.